Hello everyone, welcome back again for some more World of Warships. Today is my first battle in the Tier 5 Japanese aircraft carrier, the IJN Zuiho. So we take a little time here to do a little helicopter look around of the ship. She's not too bad looking. The aircraft stock in a stock configuration are not great, as you will see throughout this video. You can do some things with them, but for the most part, not great. This is a two-carrier battle, and the Bogue on my team does a pretty good job for the most part. He's probably far more advanced in his aircraft than I am in mine, which you'll see. So I'm launching my completely stock, obviously, first battle. Completely stock strike wing, strike aircraft, rather, because I do have a fighter squadron. Off to the east to go up the eastern wall and see what they can go find while I'm going to have my fighters scout ahead a little bit. Now, somewhat disappointing, the fighters are the A5M4s in the stock, which were pretty good with the Hosho, but they're seem like they're completely horribly outclassed in this tier, which, I mean, they are, but see, feels like they should do a little bit better than they actually do. But that's the way it goes. The problem is, I think, partially is even when you get up to the zeros, the A6M5s or A6M2s, whatever they are, that you get with the Zuiho, they're even a bit underpowered, it seems, because there's only four of them in a squadron. So there's a Bogue and a Zuiho on the other team. Obviously, those fighters right there are the Bogues because there's six of them, and there's the two fighter squadrons from the Zuiho. My fighters have discovered a Leander and start taking AAA fire from them, along with a Nurnberg and another Leander up there, so three cruisers coming down. So what I'm trying to do here is send my fighters in and engage with the enemy fighters near our cap, and hopefully get the Bogues fighters to join in with me, and then that will clear the way. At least it keeps fighters off of my own strikers over there in the east. Now watch this. I get a pretty good strike here, and my fighters get one hit, and then are immediately turned around on and lose one of me. So I got what should have been a pretty decent strike, and they got one kill out of it. Now, I'm sure that his fighters are probably upgraded all the way, but still, I get one kill and then immediately lose two fighters, and then my guys are totally wiped out. And the only one they took out was the one in the fighter sweep with the manual attack. Somewhat disappointingly, the friendly fighters from the Bogue did not join in on that fight, although he may not have even had time to see what was going on by the time my guys were knocked out. So that's half of my fighter strength gone already. And a kill ratio of 1 to 4 is not very good. So I'm going to try to join in and do what I hoped the friendly Bogue would do and join my fighters in with his, as I'm steering my carrier away from the eastern side where there are three cruisers coming down, even though we've got a fairly good amount of ship strength over there to stop them. A Leander, a Cleveland, a Fuso in New York, and a Nurnberg in an emergency. And by the time my feeble little A5M4s even get to the fight, the friendly Bogues fighters have wiped them all out, which is fine because that clears my fighters to push ahead. Engage. The farther away we're engaging the enemy, the better, unless, of course, we're severely outnumbered and we want to engage our friendly forces. But if I can keep the enemy up there at bay, keep his fighters occupied, so much the better for keeping them away from us. My strike group, having now just discovered enemy bombers taking off, is pretty close to, obviously, one of the enemy carriers. The plan was to hold the torpedo planes in reserve and send the bombers in, but with the enemy fighters discovering us, especially with two squadrons of enemy fighters coming in, it's just all hands on deck, everybody go full attack. There's not much point in taking it easy here. And the AAA does a real number on these idiots. Particularly the torpedo planes, who just get railed and wiped out. They do actually get a torpedo off, astonishingly though. And even better, the Bogue was safe from the torpedo until he slowly started moving forward and basically sails into the path of the torpedo. which I thought was pretty humorous. He's just barely moving forward now, and the torpedo actually hits him. Unfortunately, it didn't cause a flood, and the second squadron of bombers didn't make it in either. Every single plane I had up there, all 12, got wiped out. Pretty sad. And my fighters, again, get a good manual strike on a torpedo squadron, and they get one hit. What looked like should have been more damage from a manual strike ends up being with one airplane kill again. My fighters are getting chased down from behind now by enemy fighters. It's a one-on-one. I got a 50-50 chance of wiping them out. Probably not going to go very well. I would say it's less than 50-50 because of my stock planes, and there it is. I am totally out of fighter planes now. I can do nothing to help out against the enemy strikers. However, the other enemy carrier has been discovered, so I'm going to skirt my planes as close as I can around the island where he is parked and try to hug the island a bit to keep them away from the enemy fleet, which is almost completely concentrated in the west. Well, all of the survivors are concentrated in the west except for the carriers. So the friendly Bogue is going to engage the enemy fighter squadron perfectly here. And I've got my guys going in as close as I can around that to go in on the attack on the Zuiho, who's roughly there. We'll see. Mostly a guess, but I'll recorrect when I get to see. And the friendly fighters wipe out the enemy fighters, which allows my guys to no longer go on the far side, on the western side, closer to the enemy fleet, and instead they can now go around the eastern side and go after the Zuiho up there. However, the enemy fleet all coming down the western side is a bit of a concern for my own Zuiho, so I'm going to follow the Bogue and the Warspit up there in the center. Thankfully, the friendly carrier, the Bogue, had some torpedo or some fighters left in the area here, because by the time my slow, incompetent biplane bombers could get in an attack, they would have been massacred and mauled by friendly or enemy fighters. Luckily, my bombers actually get some hits, but not much else going on very well here. And the lone torpedo we got off again in the second attack goes just across the bow of the Zuiho. So my 8 torpedo planes managed to get 6 shot down, and there are only 2 attacks and 2 planes that got off torpedoes. One of them got hit and didn't even cause a flood. Pretty disappointing results for the torpedo squadron today. The bombers did alright. 4 bombs hit and 3 fires isn't too bad. Now watch this strike right here. This is beautiful. Excellently lined up to go and hit either carrier. Great chance of hitting either carrier, or hitting both carriers rather. Except for when 5 out of 6 of your torpedoes hit the enemy, and then the Bogue is pretty safe. But what a strike that was. 5 out of 6 torpedoes in on the side of his Zuiho. Good night. Excellent torpedo strike by the friendly Bogue there. So we have a Leander and a Fuso over in the west doing a pretty good job of blocking the enemy off from getting down into our cap. Well, the enemy cap is essentially wide open to the New York and Nuremberg at least. The Cleveland and Fuso over there farther in the east have a little bit farther to travel. But with the New York and Nuremberg sailing in there, a battleship and a cruiser together, they allow our Cleveland and Fuso battleship and cruiser to come in behind them and really hopefully light up the enemy in their cap. So I don't have a whole lot of planes left, but what I'm going to do is send my ship in behind the friendly ships there that are headed up, flowing up towards the enemy cap, and basically just follow along with them for my own protection and to provide whatever little bit of AAA I can. while I send my bombers over to help out the somewhat beleaguered Leander and Fuso in the west. As our New York gets torpedoed in their cap, but the Nuremberg in Cleveland finish them off quickly afterwards by the Budioni. Most of the enemy Western fleet has realized the danger to their cap and have all reversed to 180 back up, which lets the Leander and the Fuso at least swing their way up eventually. These two Arizonas are so close together that I thought I had a good chance of my bombers just coming in with a normal bomb drop and getting possibly hits on both ships. So that's what I sort of had them lined up as, but by the time my slow bombers get there, I end up just going in for a manual attack because they don't have enough chance of getting any hits. And as it is, the one bomber who makes it there gets one bomb that misses. And then the second squadron coming in loses half their planes before they even get to the bomb either. Though they do at least score a single hit with no fires. And get completely wiped out by the AAA on the Arizona, the ship which is known for not having very good AAA. Quite disappointing, as I am now down to a single bomber left. And then whatever guns my own ship can produce. Which is not the fastest ship in the fleet either, but I'm steaming as madly as I can towards the enemy cap to join in. So I decided eventually I will just sneak my carrier in between these two little islands here and just barely crawl into their cap to threaten their cap. Because if nothing else, I could serve as a distraction and draw the fire away from our actual fighting capital ships. Because really I'm not doing any good as a carrier without any airplanes if I sit all the way in the back, so trying to steer my bomber in on this very low health Cleveland here to knock him out in order to free up the friendly Bogue. Because if my planes can actually make it through, my plane can make it through. He's got a good chance of hitting, although the Cleveland gets taken out before we get there, so might as well have my bomber strike the enemy Congo. And what I should have done here was just let him go in straight on and bomb instead of trying to line him up, because it just kept him in the enemy AAA for far too long. And now I am totally without aircraft. Which makes it YOLO charge time in an aircraft carrier. So, full steam ahead. Straight into the enemy cap we go. Our ships are unfortunately getting somewhat mauled here going in solo, while the enemy battleships are all pretty concentrated, able to pretty much concentrate their fire. But little do they know, there's an aircraft carrier coming along about to distract them. Try to stay away from the, stay out of their view as much as possible, but I figure the only thing I really can do is just sit here and try to be as difficult of a target as possible. Because if I sail off to the northwest, I'm essentially going to start broadsiding to them, which is just going to make me an easier target to hit. trying to sail off into the middle here to get them to look at me and fire at me. Hopefully come charging in after me, although I'm well within range of their guns and they don't need to move any closer. Doing anything I can to try and lead one of them out of their little pack of four there for the friendly torpedo planes. But they really want to sink our warspit. But the Bayern finally is far enough ahead that that should be a pretty good torpedo shot. And it is, except our Bogue just fired them just a little bit too far ahead. Could have really massacred that Bayern with a full strike, but he did at least get one hit on him. It wasn't a total miss, just a little bit too far ahead. And this Leander did disappoint me, though, because he could have sailed farther into the cap and then dropped his single smoke charge instead of doing it outside. He's completely outside of their cap. Now, he didn't have to sail all the way up to where I am and drop the smoke, but if he'd gone into the cap and dropped the smoke, I could have turned around and hauled back and tried to get inside it a little bit at least, which maybe would have helped a little. Now, I knew I was going to take a lot of damage here from four battleships focusing on me, but that was kind of the idea. So, thus ends the first sailout, or at least thus ends my part in the first sailout of my IJN Zuiho. The battle's not over just yet, but we'll fade out here after my scolding of the Leander, and then we'll pick it up right at the end of the battle and show you the final results. Here is the Leander now as the clock ticks down, and we're about to cap them out. However, the cap out is not what's going to happen. It's going to be a ticket win by timeout. And there you have it. Still a victory with the first sailout in the Zuiho, though I did not do extremely well by any means. As you can see, one torpedo hit, five bomb hits, three aircraft shot down, one incapacitation, and three fires set. Not really a stellar first sailout by any means. And a last place finish. Yahoo! But hey, at least I shot down three planes. I did get pretty decent damage on both carriers, for what it's worth, though didn't really ultimately do a whole lot to help. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this one. I have much better Zuiho battles that I've had since then. I'll try to get a really good one and bring that to you as well, along with some more aircraft carrier battles. Thanks for stopping by and checking this one out. We'll see you guys next time.